Now we are going to discuss about biosafety cabinets. Biosafety cabinets are the box-like structures which is used to provide clean surface. But before getting into biosafety cabinet types, we should understand that why we are using biosafety cabinet or any safety cabinet. Basically, when we are working in diagnostic labs, there is three things which are in danger. One of the thing is our sample. We want that our sample should not be contaminated by any microorganisms present in the environment, so we want product safety or our sample safety. Second thing, we are working in the lab, so we want our personal safety, that we should not get infection from the material we are handling. Third thing we want is environment safety, that means the microorganism should not be exiting into the environment, because if it will exit into the environment, it may lead to several problems to the community. So biosafety cabinet are designed in such a way that none of the types of biosafety cabinet allows any microorganisms to release into the environment. It means biosafety cabinet is always going to provide you environmental safety. The only thing is, few biosafety cabinet are designed to provide only product safety, while others can provide only personal safety, while there are biosafety cabinets which can provide all three kind of safeties. So we will discuss one by one. So what safeties we are talking about here is personal safety, product safety, and environment safety. All biosafety cabinets provides environment safety. So right now we are going to talk about only other two product safeties, right? So biosafety cabinets can be classified into three types: class 1, class 2, and class 3. So biosafety cabinet class 1, class 2, and class 3. It has nothing to do directly with biosafety labels, right? Biosafety cabinets are different thing and biosafety labels are different things, right? We will discuss about that also. So biosafety cabinet class 1. So this is how it looks like. It is looking like a laminar airflow only. However, in laminar airflow, you might have seen that airflow is towards you. However, in biosafety cabinet, airflow direction is always towards the inside of the cabinet. So as you can see in this direction from this blue arrow, air is sucked by the pump which is there in the instrument. So this air is going inside. Somewhere here you are sitting and working on this, somewhere here. So as air is coming from outside, nothing can come from inside towards your face. That's why you always remain protected. However, your sample on which this outside air is touching will get contaminated. So this is not much suitable for carrying out any microbiology work. However, work in which you does not have any issues with contamination, like for example you want to do ELISA, you want to do media preparation, for those kind of things this kind of instrument can be used. See, now the last thing, see, the air which is going out from this is filtered through this HEPA filter. This blue color layer you are seeing is representing a HEPA filter. So any air which is going out from this device is getting filtered. So here now you can understand, see, this is providing environmental safety because all the air going out is clean. It does not have microbes. You are safe because you are sitting outside and air is going from behind you. So nothing is coming from inside to outside towards you, so you remains protected. While it does not provide you product safety because outside air is going into the chamber and it may contaminate your sample, right? So class 1 provides personal safety and environment safety. It does not produce product safety, so it might not be very useful. For that we use class 2 cabinets. Class 2 cabinets can be classified into two parts: class 2A and class 2B. Class 2A and B are further subclassified into class 2 A1 and A2, B1 and B2. So we will talk about all four one by one. Class 2 type A1. But as you can see this diagram here, in this air is going from front grill. Okay, air always passes through the frame of this. This is the working area. So air is passing into the frame because of this pump, and then it is pushed toward the top of the instrument where we have two filters placed. One is for exhaust air and one is for air which will be passed into the working area. So this air Some of the air will be passed into the working area after filtration, and some of the air will be exhausted outside from this chamber after filtration. So environment remain clean, the air which is coming into chamber is also clean, so your product remains clean, and obviously the air is coming from outside, nothing is coming from inside to outside, so you always remains clean. So this provides you complete protection. Now what it is, how it works, that we can discuss here again. So this is having 30% exhaust rate and 70% air is recirculated. It means 30% air will thrown out, but 70% of the air will be pushed back into the working area. It work on in negative pressure panellium, which means nothing can come inside to outside. Anything outside things can go inside, but nothing from inside can go outside. This is called negative pressure. Inflow velocity of air is 75 fpm. Fpm stands for feet per minute, right? This is very important, you remember this. Next, when we are talking about biosafety cabinet class A2, that time also this point will be very important. It can be used in biosafety level 1, 2, and 3. That's what again I am saying, it is class 2 cabinet, but it can be used in biosafety level 1, 2, and 3. That's why you don't get confused between biosafety levels and biosafety cabinets classes, right? Rest of the things I think we have already discussed. Next thing is biosafety cabinet class 2. It almost work exactly the same like how A1 is working. The only difference here is inflow velocity is more. In previous model, inflow velocity is minimum 70 fpm. However, here the inflow velocity is always going to be minimum 100 fpm. It could be more also, but minimum it is going to be 100 fpm. Rest of the things are same, so I will not discuss in detail. As you can see, the diagram is also same. Next is class 2 B1. Now here you need to see the basic difference. First difference is here we are having 3 HEPA filters, while in the previous one we were having only 2 HEPA filters, right? So that is one big difference. Some of the things we'll discuss from this diagram here, information here. So in this, the exhaust is 70% and only 30% air is getting recirculated. While in type A, both A1 and B1, exhaust was 30% while recirculation was 70%. So it is opposite here. In this also we will see negative pressure panellium. It means negative pressure will be present inside the cabinet. Nothing out inside can go outside, right? Which is very important. Inflow velocity is 100 fpm minimum. It also can be used in biosafety level 1, 2, 3. It provides personal product and obviously environmental safety. Take care. In this, as the recirculation of air is less, you can use some of the volatile toxic chemicals as well as radioactive chemicals also, but at very low level, right? And you can typically use it today for handling bacteria, virus, fungal, parasites and arboviruses. This is the diagram here. The air is again getting into the frame, okay, by the pump. It is filtered by this, pushed on the top. 30% air will be thrown into the chamber while 70% is exhausted, and cycle continues. And this is side view and this is front view of the same device. Now class 2 B2. Here important thing is 100% exhaust. Therefore it is a very good device for handling radioactive as well as volatile substances. In this also inflow velocity is minimum 100 fpm. This also provide you personal product and environment safety. In this also you can handle volatile substance, chemicals and radioactive substances. In this also you can handle bacteria, virus, fungi, parasite, arboviruses, prions and cytotoxic compounds as well. As you can see this diagram, here we are having only 2 filters. Air is going into the frame, passed to the tops. All the contaminated air which is coming from the chamber is discarded, while fresh air only circulated into the chamber. So this is how it works, right? Third category and the most advanced type of biosafety cabinet is called as class 3 cabinet, which is also known as by the name glove box. This glove box is very 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 costly device, and it is basically used in biosafety level 4, which I showed you in the previous video also, right? So in this, negative pressure pelargonium is maintained at 0.5 WG minimum. 100% air which is coming inside this is exhausted outside. Right. So this also provides you personal safety, product safety, and environment safety. In this also you can handle volatile toxic chemicals and radioactive substances. This is very suitable for working with user in biosafety level 4 to handle very very dangerous toxic powders and microorganisms. As you can see in this diagram, these whole circles representing the space for attaching gloves. As you can see in this diagram here, this is a small model. These are two gloves which is they were present inside the chamber. So here it is a large model where these circles can hold four gloves. Whatever air is coming inside this, right, air is coming inside this is circulated like this and exhausted outside. That's why it is having 100% exhaust rate. Nothing can come from outside to inside without filtration. Similarly, nothing can go outside without filtration. Right, so it provides you maximum protection. Now these structures inside you are saying are called as pass box. Through this you can put various materials like media plates, culture bottles or cultures into this chamber. As you can see more clearly in this diagram, it is a box like structure, and through this only you can pass the materials inside this instrument. This side also a pass box can be attached. Sometimes more than one biosafety cabinet class 3 can be joined to each other by using this pass box structure only. So that's all about biosafety cabinet classes. Thank you.